chance of recording a famous double over them after one win at Anfield earlier in the season. But controversy lay ahead. It was Liverpool who almost took the lead. Chris Morgan cleared this effort off the line from Michael Owen. The Reds steadily got into the game and began to play some attractive football. Scott Jones eventually knocked a long ball forward, which found its way to Fjortoft. He slipped it to Bullock, who put the ball into the box, where Redfern turned and shot to put us 1-0 up. The goal spurred the Reds on as we came forward again. This Fjortoft shot went straight to the keeper. But as half-time approached, Liverpool got an equaliser. Leonardsson found space on the left to run into the box and set up the German Karl-Heinz Riedler. Into the second half and the controversy began. Firstly, Darren Barnard was sent off for an unfortunate trip on Michael Owen. With the Reds down to 10 men, they struggled to break down the flowing football Liverpool were producing, and the visitors would have taken the lead, but David Watson produced two brilliant saves to deny Leonardsson. Soon after, Liverpool did go in front when Riedler unleashed an unstoppable shot from 30 yards to score his second of the game. Ugly scenes then followed at Oakwell. Referee Gary Willard ruled that this challenge by Chris Morgan on Michael Owen deserved a red card. In the melee that followed, a spectator ran onto the pitch to get at the referee, and only the quick thinking of Janar de Fjortoft prevented the situation being much worse. When play finally resumed, Danny Wilson brought on substitute Georgi Ristov, as nine men Barnsley battled to try and get something from the game. Ristoff was in inspirational form, and after he stole the ball from the Liverpool defence, Phil Babb brought him down for a Barnsley penalty. Neil Redfern completed the fight back as he converted the penalty for his second goal of the game. In the end, it wasn't to be enough. From a Liverpool free kick, Steve McManaman stole in to score the winning goal. To make matters worse, the Reds were reduced to eight men as Darren Sheridan was sent off.